ponytail. I remember.
So you know it.
I loved that song.
How do you know it?
I don't know. I think it just like popped up one day, or maybe I was just like, cause there was a song that kind of got stuck in my head, and I was listening to it, and then they were singing out Farytale, but I think it was the one that I was thinking of was kind of sung by a woman. It was just very high note, but it also could have been him too. I don't know. I just really liked the song.
I'm so surprised that you know it. Okay, so the next one, as Nina said, is Farytale from 2009, the winner of 2009. Now you're gonna watch it live. I cannot believe you know this.
Years ago, yes, when I was younger, I kind of liked a girl like you.
She was mine. I'm lost. You don't know it?
I don't know it.
I feel like that's a fitness workout.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Look at that. Every day we started fighting. Every night we fell in love. How'd you hear about this song?
I don't know. I was having fun on YouTube, I guess, and I just heard a song and then I couldn't find it again, and I just remembered the main word was fairy tales. Like, okay, looking it up. I don't think I ever found the original one that I was actually trying to find. But when I found this, I was just kind of like, I really like it. I'm going to keep playing it. And I haven't heard it in a really long time. And I totally forgot all about it, too.
Also, just to give you like a trivia thing, he was holding the record for the most amount of points ever won. Until they changed the scoring system.
Oh wow!
So with the new scoring system, someone beat him because you get double points almost.
Wow!
But up until 2017, he held the record.
Dang!
It wasn't even close. He was such a big favorite before the show that it was like no surprise.
So I'm assuming he won that year?
Yes.
Okay.
I would say he was probably in his 20s, but he participated again,
like
9 years later, but he looks literally just the same.
Really?
Nothing happened.
We didn't age him at all.
Someone's really proud. This was before he knew that he won. But I feel like it's probably very nice to know that you're, I mean, maybe there is pressure too. But if you're very sure on what you can do and you know that you're the favorite to win, probably like this performance is like a lot more enjoyable because you're kind of like, here I am. But then if you're the favorite to win and you're not very confident that you can sing it right or do everything correctly, I think that that's extra pressure that might actually ruin the act for you. Because they have been, over the years in Eurovision, big favorites to win. And then when the live thing happened with staging and everything, it just crashed. Was just too much pressure. But now we're gonna move to the last one of this series. I don't even know how many we filmed because this, guys, has nothing to do with the playlist that I prepared for them. We just like went through the songs, but I mean that's just like a very natural back and forth. Now we're gonna be listening to my favorite winner all times of Eurovision. But before we go there, actually, let me ask you, do you guys know any popular artist that won Eurovision?
No, not just at all. I mean, just him.
Okay.
Now that we know.
So, do you know ABBA?
No.
Oh, wait. ABBA.
Yes.
I've heard of that. I've heard of them. Yes.
So, ABBA won. You would know, I would say you know their songs. Like, maybe you don't know ABBA, like, on its own. But if you hear, like, Mamma Mia, here you go.
Oh, or, really?
Or
I
Dancing
love all
Queen.
Their songs. That's why I was confused. I was like, wait a minute. I think I know what he's talking about. But I need him to confirm it just a little bit.
Yeah, so they have a lot of songs. Like, money, money, money. Must be funny. Like,
yes.
They have, like, a lot they of popular a, songs.
They made the Broadway for that and the movies.
Yes.
For all of their songs.
Yeah, they made a musical of mm-hmm. the musical is called Mamma Mia, but I think people know already the fans. And the other big artist that won Eurovision was Celine Dion.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah.
I didn't know that either. I don't know what. I don't even
Wait,
know her
what,
background,
what country
honestly.
Does
I just
she
know
represent?
Celine Dion.
Switzerland.
Switzerland, okay.
Do you want to listen to her?
I thought she was American this
yeah.
whole time. I have been woke. Yes.
Okay, so since we're going to watch Celine also, this is not gonna be the last video. Let's go for Celine in 1988.
Oh wow.
Dang.
This is before she was famous. She became famous afterwards.